Good morning, students, and welcome back to the online classes of science. Myself, Mittal Javia from St. Thomas School, Mova, going to teach you science. See, students, now your unit test is over. I hope that all of you have done well in the test. And before test, we have started one chapter, chapter number 13, Fun with Magnet, right? So, what was there in that chapter? Up to here we have done, right? Up to here we have completed. Then also, let me recall the chapter from the beginning. Let me give you the overview of the chapter. There was a two person, Pahali and the Bujo, who went to the place where the heap of the waste material was there, right? Like this. In that, one crane was just moving from there, and the its handle was lowered a block over a heap, right? Like this. And this is a block. And what they noticed that the iron from this one, the block started at sticking to that block, right? This one. So they concluded that there was a magnet on the basis of the block. So this thing we have done. So now let's start from the how magnet were discovered. See, how magnets were discovered? It is said that there was a shepherd named Magnes who lived in an ancient Greece. He used to take his herd of sheep and goats to the nearby mountains for grazing. See, what they are telling that? There was a shepherd named Magnes. He usually take his, goat and the sheep for the grazing. He would take a stick with him to control his herd. The stick had a small piece of iron attached at one end. What they were telling that the person who was having a stick with him when he was taking his sheep and the goats at the time, the stick was having a small piece of iron attached at one end. One day he was surprised to find that he had to pull hard to free his stick from a rock on the mountainside. See what they were telling that on the one day that Magnes went to the mountainside with his herd, and what happened over there? There was something sticked into that stick, and it was very difficult to free it from that. It seems as if the stick was being attached by the rock. See what they're telling that one rock was attached by the stick. Okay, the rock was a natural magnet, and it attracted the iron tip of the shepherd's stick. See, what they are telling that the magnet attracts toward the iron, as we know that, okay. So, that was the natural magnet of rock, and that attached to the shepherd's stick. Why? Because shepherd's, in that stick, he was having a small piece of iron at one end, right? It is said that this is how the natural magnet were discovered. So, this is how the natural magnet get discovered. Such rocks were being the name magnetite. See, that type of rocks were named as a magnetite. Perhaps after the name of that shepherd, the magnetite contains iron. Some people believe that the magnetite was the first discovered at a place called the Magnes. See, it was the place where the magnet was discovered, and that was the Magnes. The substance having the property of attracting iron are known as magnet. See, the substance that is having the property of attracting towards the iron, that is considered as the magnet. It's called a magnet. This is how the story goes. So, they are telling that this is how the discovery of the magnet was a story, and it was a how it begins. In any cases, the people now have discovered that certain rocks have the property of attracting the pieces of iron. They also found the small pieces of this rock have same properties. See what they're telling that nowadays the people have discovered the certain rocks having the property of attracting piece of iron, right? They are having the same property like the magnet. They have found this, that people have been discovered. They named thus naturally occurring materials magnet. Later on, the process of making the magnet from pieces of iron was discovered. See, what they're telling that whatever the pieces of iron was discovered, from that the from the natural magnet, the later on the process of making the magnet have been found. Those are known as the artificial magnet. See, first we found that shepherds found a natural magnet, right? And nowadays, now the people are making this an artificial magnet. Nowadays, the artificial magnets are prepared in a different shapes. Yes, see students, many times you are bringing the magnet in the school of different shapes. Sometimes it's a circle and square and two cube step magnet and that all things. What teachers were doing, they are just taking the magnet from you and keeping in the drawer. Why? Because for the whole day you guys were playing over there. So those are the different magnet. They are the artificial magnet. Okay. The magnets are prepared in a different shapes. So artificial magnets are prepared in a different shapes. For an example, the bar magnet, horseshoe magnet, cylindrical or a ball ended magnet. See, those are the examples of artificial magnet. See, it's a bar magnet, it's a horseshoe magnet, it's a cylindrical magnet, and this is a ball ended magnet. Okay. Magnet figure 13.4 shows a few such magnets. See, those are the names of the types of the shapes of the magnet. Okay. So students, let me tell you one more thing, that today we'll stop over here, right? And what you guys have to do, you have to just go through from the beginning of the chapter till here. It's your homework. You have to read your chapter up to here, because the many days have been passed before this we have started this one chapter, right? So you have to complete it up to here, reading portion, right? So tomorrow it will be more easy for you to understand the remaining chapter. So we'll stop it over here, and the remaining portion we will complete in our next video. So students, that's all for the day. Have a good day.